So just now we are adding iodine in tubes and they are being filled and kept in the rake. This is the same way you have done in your first year when you have estimated the activity of amylase. Now we are starting the practical of effect of pH on activity of amylase. First of all, you can see very nicely that we have prepared 1% of the starch solution, 1% NaCl solution, and we have 3 beakers, 3 flasks in which we have written 4 pH, pH 7 and pH 9.2, acidic, neutral and alkaline. Now we will first of all mix the content of starch and NaCl in this flask. We are going to take 15 ml of starch. So first of all I will add 10 ml with the help of 10 ml pipette, 10 ml starch. I am adding, you can see very nicely. Now some more 5 ml I am going to add. Yes, now I have taken 5 ml of 1% starch. I am adding it in this mixture flask. Now putting the flask of starch and pipette aside. Now I will take 1% NaCl. I am going to take 3 ml of it. Of the NaCl solution I am adding in the starch. So now you can see that 15 ml of starch I have added and 3 ml of NaCl solution I have added. So now this is the total quantity, 18 ml, and out of this I am going to distribute 66 ml in these 3 small sized flasks. So now first of all I will take 6 ml, adding in the first flask, already added, putting aside. Now I am taking again another 6 ml. Yes, in the another flask of neutral pH, and then rest of the 6 ml. I am going to add in flask of acidic pH. So now you can see that all these 3 flasks are ready with us. And now I am going to add the pH tablet in the first flask. This is our pH tablet and it is of pH 4, you can see pH 4. I I am adding the content of this capsule inside to make the pH acidic. Now I am going to mix it well. Now we will go for neutral pH. I will take in my hand the capsule of neutral pH. And adding the quantity inside the flask. Now I am going to mix this properly. Now the turn is of alkaline pH. I am going to take one capsule of pH 9.2 and you can see that I am adding in the flask of 9.2. Entire quantity, all the content you have to add inside and then mix it properly to get the uniform solution. Now after this much thing, we are going to take our salivary amylase. This is the amylase which is taken from the mouth. Okay, it is 1 ml in quantity. Now we are going to dilute this amylase, salivary amylase, as 1:20. So that we will do with the help of distilled water. Now I will take 19 ml of distilled water to make it diluted 1:20. Bahut kharab dikh raha hai. અનુબેન બીજી પીપેટ આપો ને, પીપેટ નો કંટ્રોલ જ નથી થતો. વોટર 10 ml. સો વી હેવ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટેડ નાવ ઓલરેડી પ્રોપરલી યુનિફોર્મલી મિક્સ્ડ ફોર pH 4. Going to prepare salivary amylase solution. I am taking 10 ml and now I will take only 9 ml. So that will be our dilution of 1:20. So our amylase enzyme is already diluted. So now we will give the tag also to this particular diluted amylase, that is 1:20. Okay, fine. Now our all pH flasks are ready and we are going to keep it in the water bath at 37 degree centigrade temperature. So that is also ready with us. This is our water bath. Already temperature is maintained inside and we are keeping this ફ્લાસ્ક ફોર સમ ટાઈમ ઇન વોટર બાથ.
તમારે મને પેલું કાણા બાબુ બાસ્કેટ નાનકડું.
નાવ વી આર ગેટિંગ રેડી અલ્કલાઇન પીએચ ફ્લાસ્ક એન્ડ બાય ધ ટાઈમ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ ટેલ યુ નાવ દેટ વી આર then after going to carry out the essay of Homiles in which you are going to see the this type of color formation in the initial number of iodine tubes. You can see very nicely that blue color is already developed because of the presence of the starch which will mix up with the iodine and it will give the color. So this will be our standard for starch. So this is considered as the negative control, okay? Or you can consider it as a starch control. Now in this basket, perforated basket, we are keeping all our three flasks for little incubation.
Thank you,
okay, for little incubation, okay, and we will wait for some time. And then after, we are going to add 1 ml of Homiles enzyme in each of the flask, and then after we will carry out the assay of Homiles enzyme.